The recently elected National Assembly has convened and has started the process of selecting a new president. That involves picking just over two dozen members who will make that selection, and it's expected to mark the first time in decades that a Castro will not hold that title. It is widely presumed here that the current first vice president, Miguel Diaz-Canel, will be their choice, the Communist Party likely looking to send a message of continuity. To be clear, the outgoing president, Raul Castro, will remain head of the Communist Party, a powerful position that is expected to give him ample influence in the years to come. So many here on the island do not necessarily foresee any drastic changes. And there are some in the younger generation that were hopeful of some expansion of limited economic reforms and more opportunities. They don't necessarily see it happening this time around, although there are some that remain hopeful. In the United States, Cuban exiles and Cuban American leaders see this as not a true election at all. They see it as a mere passing of the torch from one dictator to another, with practically no chances of improving relations between the United States and Cuba. Manuel Bojorquez, CBS News, Havana.